Hello everybody, I am going to show you actually taking this hard drive apart from the beginning, minus a few screws. I was about to harvest some more magnets out of some drives for my bicycle wheel there, and so I thought I'd like really show how this happened. So, already taken some out that I can get to. Now I gotta take the labels off like I was telling you guys about. So I just use a razor blade and cut those open. There's one there for sure. I know there's gonna be one there. You can peel the whole label off too, but you know, why bother? I'm feeling for a little dimple. There's another one. This drive actually has a whole bunch of screws, a little more complicated than the other one I showed you. Maybe something under there, but I don't think so. This one label here, which may or may not have anything. Nope, it's just a hole. Okay, so again, I'm using this screwdriver kit, excuse me. Marva Freight's got all those little specialty screwdriver bits. Okay, then the circuit board. Now you can see this one's got this guy, this cable. So I'm just gonna cut the tape holding it here. I don't like destroying anything, because you never know when you might be able to use it. Okay, and then these little clip things, you just gotta push these little tabs out like that, and then this cable comes out of there. It's like so. Pretty simple. Okay, then we got about what, 4 screws on the circuit board. Boom, that comes off. Put this little guy in. Yeah, see, this one has a couple more hidden screws. That's why I was saying I always trick to take the circuit board off too. Well, something's rattling around in there now. Anyway, it's loose. Okay, now you got this one is the gasket type. So I just use a screwdriver because there's a little bit of space right here. Just pry it off. There's your gasket. Okay, so here's our magnet assembly, our little arm. The thing I was telling you is you can't always swing this all the way over, so that's why I end up taking this apart. Usually these screws are even smaller, so I change bits. And there we are. And so much for a hard drive. I didn't trust this one. What is it, a Desk Star, like a 60 gig, but these were like feeling drives. So I don't trust it. So I get some magnets. Yay. Hopefully more than just one. I think there might be two in this one. I ultimately I want to put 24 magnets on this wheel. I think I mentioned that already. I got 18 on there now. It's kind of fun. I need to make a new coil for it too. This one I got now is pretty small, I'm telling you that. Okay. So there we go. Now, I think I got them all out of there. Yep. So there's your holding ring. Then, gonna take this little guy out here too. This and the spacer ring. The other disc is not coming off yet. So, this one, might be ready to come off already here. Alright, there, that thing came off, that'll help. There it came. There's the other disc. Now, let's see. Is that one screw that didn't come out? Screw, I guess. Something's spinning. Well, there might be a bolt or something there. Let's see. Alright. I'm gonna separate this top bracket. Wedging it with a screwdriver. There we go. I think it was the magnet to them. So yeah, this is a dual magnet one. Those are some pretty nice ones. So here's what I'm saying. You can put the bracket back together to clamp them in the vise in order to pound those magnets out, but there's that, and that finally came out. And then you can take these two out. It's like a circuit board plug kind of thing. And bada boom, bada bing, you got most of it apart. Now if you want to get the motor out too, you already got that loose. So these are bigger ones. Got three screws holding that motor in. You have it. One hard drive in pieces. Wow, it feels like a nice bearing in that one. Like I say, this is a newer drive. Most of the other ones I've been doing are older drives. So there we have it. Talk to you next time.